the Syracuse Mini Nationals. And one of the greatest things about this show is that not only do you see the model cars and the diecast, you get to meet guys like this, John D'Agostino. What's happening?
Oh, real good. It's great to be here at Syracuse Nationals.
It's a great show. You brought the big guns today. This car is called Elvis. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, this is the Elvis II tribute car. This is the second series of Elvis. I built the same type of car, but it was a Seville. It was a hard top, made it into a half top back in 2006. The car went over so big that one of my clients happened to see the car going through the auction, and it ended up being sold to somebody in Paris, France. And I met him the next day over at the Pebble Beach Concourse d'Elegance. He said, John, I want you to build me another Elvis car. So basically, I told him, I said, if you want to go right to the top, you got to start with the Biarritz convertible. So we found the car. I found the car for him, a couple $100,000 car to start with. 11 months later, here it is.
So in other words, this was not a junkyard find. This was a real rare car to begin with, and you had it, and you did some beautiful stuff to it.
I found it in Monterey. It was actually 95% finished, ready to go to Pebble Beach. I bought it there, and then right after that, I took it to the shop, dismantled the whole car. Yeah, like I said, it was a pristine car to start with. So,
and you've done some really subtle but just really beautiful stuff. We talked just a couple moments ago. You sectioned the windshield frame 4 full inches.
4 full inches.
Now, of course, you can't use the glass that came with that. So you had to do something really special to get the windshield. What happened with that?
I have a little trick here. Back in the mid-90s when I was doing shows in Europe, I met somebody from Finland, and they have a glass company, and then they custom make windows. So what we did, he flew down, and they make actually a mold and a pattern of the opening, and they send that thing to Helsinki, Finland, and they actually make the window there.
Now, this is a complex curve. This is one of the old GM wraparound windshields. You don't just take this and cut it. You have to heat this thing up and bend it so that it'll fit, that it's also got to fit up into the channel. That's remarkable. I mean, the planning involved in that's incredible.
Well, a lot of people actually get a stock window and they either cut it or grind it.
Right.
Problem is anything that wraps around, there's a lot of stress in this section here. Mm-hmm. They end up cracking. They could crack right at the end. You could have an eighth inch left and you think you got it made, and all of a sudden, boom, it heats up and it cracks.
Oh,
so rather than go through 5 or 6 or 10 windows, stock windows, I custom make all my glass. And actually, I've Roy Brizio or Steve Mole, even Chip Foose, they have the contact that I gave them to have their windows made the same way. And it's basically, it's a lot of money to actually do it.
Right.
But in America, it would probably cost you $20,000 to do a window.
Right.
Over there, for $7,000 or $8,000, you have a window made in Finland. And you got it in 6 weeks.
And you're also saving yourself a lot of time trying to make something that's not going to fit.
They professionally come, and it takes them a good 8 to 10 to 12 hours to actually go around the opening and to strengthen it. It looks like a bridge when it's all done. You can see all the conduit and everything, and it's sturdy as could be. And then they make the glass off that.
That's absolutely amazing. Now, you've retained most of the car's stock bodywork. You haven't, changed anything of that. Tell us about the tonneau cover back here. Was that an original piece to the Biarritz?
No. Since the car's cut 4 inches, we have a German half-inch white top on it. It's a canvas top. It's a gorgeous piece. And what we did here, because of the chopping at 4 inches, everything goes down 4 or 5 inches also back here. So the stock one probably stuck up 4 or 5 inches. We made this out of aluminum, a flat aluminum. We actually formed it. It's made into two pieces. We got the custom that's made out of brass, all chrome plated. That comes off very easily with wing nuts. It's two pieces. They fit into leather pouches that I made just like this. They fit into there. They go right into the trunk. Go into the car, press a button. Within 20 seconds, it's done. The top is up, all locked in and everything. So it's very easy and it's very functional.
Well, that's one of your hallmarks, though. So, you're not talking about, well, we made it out of fiberglass. Not to knock fiberglass.
Right.
Everything done here.
I do everything
built
in metal.
By hand.
Everything
that's
in metal.
Amazing.
Even inside, if I do a console, it's not fiberglass. It's made into metal. If I roll a console into the center, come in the back with some of my cars, everything is sheet metal or aluminum.
Right.
Yeah.
Just incredible. How many coats of paint are we talking on this baby? Because this is gorgeous.
There's about 30 coats. It's all house of color. It's a custom mixed ice blue pearl. And Art Hemsel in Concord, California actually did all the colors and all the fades and all the scallops and striping. He did all that. But it's got the gold pearl accents, ice gold pearl on top of that. And what we did, we actually crushed up 2 carats of diamonds, crushed it, and used that into the clear. And it's got the little bit of specks here and there over the whole car. So there's actually 2 carats of crushed diamonds, very small. And we actually went through the gun there, and it's actually all over the car. Then we clear coated it, color sanded it. Here it is.
It is absolutely flawless. There is no way that any camera work we could do to would give people the impression of this thing. It is a huge gorgeous, slammed to the ground. I mean, you dropped it how much?
Actually, it's all air ride suspension. All you have to do is just press this like an iPod.
Right.
It's all computerized. You just start the car up, automatic car goes up 4 inches. So you can set it anywhere you want. So it's at ride height.
Right.
If I want to lower it as I'm going or when I'm stopped, you can manually go through it. It all has sensors. If you go on a road that's like this, it all adjusts. So the car is never going down the road like this. You could put a 400-pound person in that front seat.
Right.
Car could go this way, but automatically it levels out. So it's called AccuAir. It's a new style air ride suspension from California.
That amazes me. You know, again, you have the old school. You have the hands-on approach. You know, do that, but you also have the new school, the technology, the stuff you're putting into these cars.
If you look at that grill, there's about 190 chrome spears added to the stock NOS grill in it, and they're all pre-drilled. That took a week just to do that. Look at the chrome spears all going across, top,
wow,
bottom. You got the Lucas style flamethrowers from the early 60s that Gene Winfield used in all his famous show cars.
Sure, with the darts in the center.
Yeah.
And so, here we have.
Oh, this is, I had all this cast in Seattle, Washington.
Right.
There's actually $20,000 of all the silver, all the diamonds, all the blue topaz. There's actually 5 pieces throughout the car. See one on the hood, there's one in the front with the crest, cat crest. That's all custom cast.
You better move these ropes back a little bit.
I know. Tell me about it. Yeah, I did it with the first Elvis car, and it did so good. It was such an impact adding this, because Elvis was flamboyant.
Sure.
So I had to do something that was over the edge. So it was went over so good that I had to do it on the Elvis II car.
Now, you said mostly the chrome, you said the car was 95% complete.
Yeah, but I ended up redoing all the chrome, everything. Everything was pulled apart and redone.
It's uniformly beautiful. I mean, there was nothing on this car.
Oh, no, it was a gorgeous car. Gorgeous car. And I went with my signature series wire wheels, the 48-spoke CAD wires.
Beautiful.
Coker tires, the Coker wide wides.
Right.
Custom logo. These are done in Louisville, Kentucky. It's got the D'Agostino. They're all color coordinated. If you look at the inside where D'Agostino is, it's the ice blue to match that. Because this is sort of a golden anniversary car, I did this in gold plating.
Right.
Yeah, so there's a lot of tricks to it.
You put a lot of time and energy into this.
And that interior is a work of art if you're looking at it real close. Basically what I did, I had the consoles made by a guy named Bob Devine in Pittsburgh, California, front and rear. We went with the crystal ashtray, and it's funny because I was in Monterey doing the Concours d'Elegance last year looking for an ashtray for this car. For some reason, I don't know how this could happen. I went to a thrift shop that had, you know, crystal ashtrays and a bunch of other stuff. I found that ashtray and I looked at it, I says, you know what? This ashtray looks for it just looks like my other car. It can't be, because there's only one of them. I looked at my other Elvis car, looked at this, exactly the same ashtray.
Wow.
Exactly the same.
Meant to be, man.
Meant to be. So I end up getting a little decanter for the back to match that. The Prince's phone that Elvis used in some of his cars.
That matches the paint.
That matches the paint. That was done by Hemsel, all custom painted. The interior, this is Swedish leather. It's the white with the gold pearl coming through. That's all custom done. This is out of Sweden. This is out of Australia. This is calfskin.
Wow.
If you feel that, it's like glove leather.
Oh my God, yeah. Wow.
This is from an early 60s luxury car. This is brocade.
That's what I was going to say.
The brocade. There's a place over in actually Portland, Oregon that has a lot of the stock factory fabrics. This new old stock fabric.
Wow.
Brand new stuff. So I end up doing this.
You have resources that are unbelievable.
Yeah. Yeah. And probably one of the most fascinating things that nobody's used, and not even Rolls Royce. See, Rolls Royce uses English wool carpeting.
Right.
Then they go the lamb's wool mats. They just do the mats and lamb's wool. What I did, I found a discontinued Rolls-Royce color from the early 80s. I found out through channels, one guy had 16 pills of this, what do you call it? And it was all powder blue. And if you look at it, it matches the car perfect. And what I did, not only I did the mats, I did everything. I did the carpet, mats, the interior is done the same, the trunk is done the same as this. It's all done, it's very, very, very expensive. So that's all original lamb's wool from New Zealand. So you got New Zealand, you got Australia, and you got Sweden there.
Yeah, it's a multinational effort.
That's it. That's it. After the show, the Syracuse Nationals, I'm going to ship the car back to Peterson Museum. We're going to display it there for about a month to 6 weeks. Because this car just came out of, just before here, it was on the concourse on Rodeo. Father's Day on Sunday. I drove it from the Peterson, 2 miles, this car and my 52 CAD, custom. I drove it over there, and I actually took most elegant car on Rodeo. picked by the mayor, Jimmy Dilshad, been mayor of Beverly Hills forever. Picked this car as the most outstanding, beautiful car, so that was a big turn on. I drove it back to the Peterson, I'm all happy, and here 2 weeks later, ship it to Syracuse to do the show here. We're gonna do some celebrity guest appearances at Graceland. Every 2 weeks, we're gonna bring a different celebrity there. So I'll be basically flying to Graceland every 2 weeks to do celebrity appearances with them. Then after that, car goes to Sweden, goes to Finland, goes to Norway, goes to Belgium. I have 8 car shows in Europe, actually on schedule for 2011 so far. It's great to be here at Syracuse Nationals. I'm telling you, this is probably the best show on the right coast, without a doubt. Great to be here.
Thanks, John.
Okay,
thanks,
take care.
Thanks to everybody. You stick around. Be back in a few minutes.
Take care.